Hi children, welcome back again. So in the last video for the first standard, the fifth chapter, we have discussed already when we do eat the food. So we have discussed about breakfast and even we have discussed about the lunch. So in this video, we'll continue the next time to eat food, when it should be. So after two complete meal, first one is breakfast, second one is lunch, and third one must be the dinner. It contains the complete food again to energize our body, and we eat in the evening, in the night. This is called as the dinner. Again, the dinner contains the food item like which will give energy to our body. That may be the cereals, that may be the grains, and that may be the vegetable, that may be the milk, that may be the vegetable salad, that may be the rice sambar. Even we eat these all items little, so it can give us the healthy food or complete food to our body. So for example, the grains and the cereals will help to grow our body. They will give a lot of protein, and milk will help to give calcium to our body and protein to our body. Similarly, the egg will give the protein to our body, and then the leafy vegetables and other vegetables, they will give energy to our body. And the meat, even fish, they are also going to give us a lot of protein. Even the paneer is also going to give protein. The curd, the milk, the sweet items also from the milk product. We can eat these all milk products to get a different type of our body, which will help us to maintain our body healthy. So like this, we have complete three meals for a one day: breakfast, lunch, dinner. Okay, now let me know when we have to eat the breakfast. Yes, of course, morning, 7:30 to, or from 7:30 we can take the breakfast, and it should not extend beyond the 10 o'clock. Okay, within 9:30 the breakfast should be taken. 7:30 to 9:30 the breakfast should be taken. And after that, and you should not eat the kurkure, chips or biscuit in the breakfast. You should eat the food which like idli, dosa, pad or paratha, or you can eat the masala chapati, or you can eat the masala roti. Other than this, you can eat the pulao. So like this, the food must be containing the lot of vegetable and fruits. So like that, or juice, fruit salad, or vegetable salad. So like this food also you can use in the breakfast, which can give us the sudden energy. And even you can use the milk after this eating all. And in the afternoon, again the energizing food materials. We know that complete meal or complete diet, which contains different types of bhaji made up of different vegetables, and you can eat the fruit after eating the food. And even you can use milk. Even in the lunch also, you can use the egg, meat, fish. So like this, and the dry fruits, which will give us the energy, protein, oil, fat, which is going to help our body to maintain well. And then even in the dinner, you can use the full meal or the light meal. It should give the complete all type of proteins, vitamins and the minerals. That one we call as the dinner. And then after the good food, after when do we eat three times for one day, which we must eat. And then let us discuss about what is about the bad food, the which type of food we must not eat. So I think you must have heard about the junk foods. Dried one kept in a fridge for a long time, fried one, and which is prepared by using lot of oil, lot of fatty materials and some other fatty materials, which is not at all good for our health, but it is going to give only the taste, only for the taste purpose we eat. By eating like that food, which is going to give us very bad effect on our body, then we must not eat the fried and made prepared by a lot of oil such type of food we must not eat. Those all are called as the junk foods. They are not at all going to give any energy or any good effect on our body. Totally they will give bad effect and only for the taste purpose. By eating that one, we may have the obesity, we may have the heart problem when the days increase, or we may have the cholesterol problem, we may have the kidney problem, we may have eyes and skin may lose the sensitivity, and our tongue may lose the sensitivity, eyes may lose the vision power. So like this, we have lot of bad effects on our body by eating those junk foods. Before first of all, we will get the stomach problem. If we eat lot of the junk food, we will get the stomach problem. Okay, because that will be impure, that will be no fresh, it is not at all fresh. So only it is cooked sometime and it is kept in under the refrigerator. When it is needed again, it is made fried again and it is given only for the taste purpose. So we must not prefer the junk food for a regular use. So for any time or for occasionally, only once in a month, twice in a month, it's okay. But every day or every in a month 4 to 5 times by eating these all junk foods, lot of junk foods, making it favorite, it is not at all good for our health. So like this, the junk food is giving the bad effect on our health. Then the food has 2 categories. One is good food, then next one is junk food. And the food must be eaten in 3 different times: breakfast, lunch, dinner. Morning breakfast, afternoon lunch, and night dinner. And along with this food, we can use the milk, butter, cheese, curd, ghee, and the dry fruits, and boiled egg, meat, fish. So like this also we can use for extra energy, so which can complete our food. Then children, we all are thinking about food and all, no? Then have you ever thought, from where do we get the food? Yeah, of course, in the grocery shop. But to the grocery shop, from where the food will come? Yes, we have 2 main sources for the food. First one is plant and second one is animals. As I'm telling you, we must eat the meat, we must eat the egg, we must eat the milk and milk products, and we must eat the fish. So what are these all are? These all are animal products. These all are coming from the animal. And I am telling you to use lot of vegetables, lot of fruits, lot of cereals, grains, and the pulses, and the vegetable, leafy flower and flower vegetable, different type of vegetables. Then these all will come from the plant. Then which are the 2 source of the food? Plants and the animals. So I hope you have understood whatever we have discussed in this video for the 5th lesson of the 1st standard. And let us end this video by here. And before ending, you can take some questions, or you can go for solving of the exercise. Here ends your lesson, and you can solve the exercise, and you can go through that one to make perfect and read once again and make it perfect and understand. Okay, I hope you will do this all work, and let us start the next chapter in the next week. Till then, take care of yourself. Bye-bye.